Hello and welcome to WordPress Tutorials. In today's video, I'll show you how to convert HTML template just like this. This is a new template from ThemeForest, and I'll show you how to convert it to a WordPress theme, and you can make a WordPress news website from that theme. So this template is available on ThemeForest for $19, and they do not have any WordPress theme for this. So I'll show you how to manually convert it to a WordPress theme. Okay, I already have this theme, this Miranda HTML template downloaded on my desktop, and this is the folder. And if we open in a new browser, then you can see that they did not include the images, but at least they showed us which sizes will be required for this theme. So 512 by 512, 800 by 495. Please remember these sizes, because this will be needed when we build our theme, and we will add these sizes to our functions.php. Okay, what we need for this theme, basically we will need two files, the style.css. If you open any other theme, for example, this is my test website. Let me show you. This is a test website, and currently I'm using Enjoy News theme and 2021 within this installation. So currently this theme is active, and if you open the front end, this is what it looks like. But I'll convert this website to this design by converting this to HTML to WordPress first. So what we will need is style.css and index.php first. So first of all, let's make a new website, a new folder for the theme in WP content and themes. I'll give the name my news theme and open it. But for example, I'll open the style.css from an existing theme, because we will need the comment section here, which includes the theme name, the theme URI, author details, and description, etc., tags, etc. So I'll use this as a template. Let me save this file as the new theme style.css. Leaving the comments, I'll delete all the other styling options, because this was for another theme, and just replace this name by your own name. Let me use my name, Suhail Ahmed, news WordPress theme, and change your author URI. Or let's just Suhail Ahmed, and the same as WordPress. Okay, type some description. Delete existing website details, domain name will be Suhail Ahmed News, and type some tags such as one column, two column, right sidebar, flexible header, etc. Okay, once you save this file in the new folder, open my new theme. There is only one styles.css which we just created. So if you come to your theme folder and refresh it, it will still need one more file, which is style.css. The following themes are installed but incomplete. Template is missing. Standalone theme is need to have index.php. So the second file we have to create is index.php. So come to your Miranda template and copy index.php along with assets, because we will need assets as well. These files will also be required, but later. Let me just show you the home page, and then we can move forward. Copy assets and index.html here. Now, change HTML index.html to index.php. Now open the index.php. We will have to make some changes here because the assets are getting from the root folder, while currently the WordPress root folder is not pointing to the template directory, which is this one. Currently it will point to the test folder here. Everything we get from the root folder, just like this, will come from this main folder. So what we will do is to add a template directory URI to each asset, such as this and this. But let me just show you how this theme will look like after we activate it. Okay, after activating the theme, you can see that theme is not active yet, but you can see that there is no thumbnail here, the screenshot. So open your template from the theme forest, or you can add any screenshot, but I'll add the actual screenshot of the theme. Press print screen if you are using Windows, and open Paint and paste the screenshot here. Print screen and then paste it. Okay, print screen is not working while we are working. So we will just catch a new image from our asset folder. Come to images and thumbs. You can choose any image. Let me choose this one. Copy and open your theme folder and paste it here and rename it screenshot.png. Okay, now if we refresh the backend, you can see that the theme have now the screenshot attached. Okay, now let's activate the theme and let's see what it looks like on the front end. So you can see it looks like a broken theme, a broken website, because no assets are loaded. If you right click and click on view page source, then you can see that assets are coming from the root. And if you click any of the root, you can see that it's coming from WordPress, the root folder of the site, and then assets. While our assets are in the WP content, themes, and my news theme. If we copy this path and add to the assets manually here with a backslash, removing the slash, removing the backslash with replace it with slash, save it, add one slash before assets, and refresh this PNG PNG thing, click on it. Then you can see WP content, themes, news theme, my news theme, and asset. So this thing needs to be added, but we will also do not use this because this is a static thing, static string. So a function called my theme URI is to be used here. So let's add PHP tags first and add a slash after the PHP tags, then type echo get theme directory URI and then function, and let's see if it's working. Let's refresh the page. WP, okay, some error. So okay, get the template or get template URI. Save it, refresh it. Okay, now it's working. So it's automatically added the theme path to each asset. So what we will do to replace all these assets, copy this thing and press Control F to find, and in replace paste this one. But from the above, type double quotes and add double quotes here as well and click on replace all, and it will replace all these assets with the template URI. Now save the file and let's see how the templates looks like now. Okay, with some assets it looks a lot better than the previous view. Okay, now what we will have to do is first we will design the single page, then we will come to the home page and design all these things and add these things in the Redux framework. But first let's add the single.php. So come to your template where the HTML files are existed. So copy single.php, single.html, and paste it in your template and change it to PHP. Okay, now if you click on any news, then it will be opened in the single.php or single.html, but this is the template. Come to the actual website, the actual theme. Okay, single.html is not working yet. Or because it's a static link from the HTML, let's just add a new post. My new post, and this is content area. Save the post and let's see how it looks like on the front end. Okay, now you can see that this page is also disturbed. So what we will do is do the same thing for the single.php as well. Press Control F and in replace click replace all, and all assets will be replaced. Save the file and refresh the single page, and single page is working. But the single page data is not according to the post, it's just static data from the HTML file. So now we're working on this thing. You can see that the title is my new post and the description is this is content area. So what we will do is replace this thing and the description with our actual data. So come to single.php, scroll down where the title is located. Here in H1, type in PHP tags the title, and it's a function. But before we do this, after closing the header, type the post for the single page. Okay, now refresh the single page and let's see if the title is changed. Okay, now come to the description area. It will be the content area or entry content, entry wrapper, excerpt. This is excerpt and this is the content area. Fashion. Main content. Okay, replace the content of this div. With a function called the content. In PHP tags, type the content and close the function. These are some functions which are commonly used in WordPress: the title, the post, and the content. And the other function I used for WordPress is get template directory URI. These are not PHP functions, these are used specifically for WordPress. Okay, now if you refresh the page, then the content area will also be replaced by our content. This is content area, and the T is capital. This is because the styling in style.css, but in the template folder, the assets folder, style.css. This one. Okay. Now we have our single page and our home page. Let me show you how to make this menu working. You can similarly add the thumbnail here. Let me just show you first how to edit the thumbnail. We will have to add the thumbnail support in functions.php. Let's just make a functions.php file, copy any PHP file and remove all the contents, change it to functions.php with an S at the end. Okay, open it, remove everything and start the PHP tags. Type add action, and this is a function for after theme setup, after setup theme, and this is our custom function. You can type anything here, but you will have to build this function above or below this option. Okay, in my case I'll type wct theme setup function. Okay, now copy this function name and add it, declare a function with double brackets and close it. Now what we will add is thumbnail support and some other theme supports. So I'll use theme support function, add theme support and post thumbnails. For adding thumbnails to our posts or pages, I'll remove portfolio and WC teams because we do not have these custom post types. We only have posts and pages for this. So after saving the functions.php, let's refresh the edit post page, and there will be a featured image added to the new post. So click on featured image, add a featured image and update. Okay, now we will get this featured image and add it to the single page here, 1240 by 700, and remember that I asked you to remember these things, these thumbnail sizes, so we can add them to the functions.php. So what we will do is add a line here, add image size, and this will be the image size name. You can do any name, but the best way is to add this thing, this string, as your name, your thumbnail name. So 1240 by 700 is our first thumbnail. 1240 by 700, and these are the actual dimensions for that image. 1240 by 700. This is just the name. We will get this thumbnail size by calling this string. I'll show you in a while. So we can add them to the single.php. Okay, we will add some more sizes. We have 512 by 512. So copy this line and add it here. 512 by 512. The actual dimensions are 512 by 512 square. And this true means that it will never disturb the aspect ratio of the image, and it will crop the image according to these sizes. Okay, this is 512. Okay, let's see what other sizes we have. Come to home page of your template. So 512 by 700 is another thumbnail size. Copy this and add it, 512 by 700, and the dimensions are 512 by 700. Okay, look for another 800 by 495. 800 by 495. Okay, These line means that when you upload an image, let me show you. If you come to your WP admin, come to media, or you can just add a new image by uploading a new file. When you upload the image to this WordPress website, then it will automatically generate all these thumbnail sizes. But first let's see that it's larger than 1240, because that thumbnail will not be generated if this image is smaller than that. All these images are smaller. Let's see for another option. Let's just custom edit any file for that resolution. Okay, now we can use this file and I can show you how it will generate all these thumbnails. Click as set as featured image and save it. Now open your website WP content folder and uploads current month, and you can see that these thumbnails are already generated. Okay, the file name, the actual file name was already 1024x500, so that will be included in all thumbnails, but the actual thumbnail size will be after this hyphen. So 150x150 is this one. This one is 300x146, and now our own sizes, 512x512. Here is the 512x512. This is 512x700. And 768x375, it's a custom size. And 800x495 is our size. 1024x500 is custom size by WordPress. And 1240x700. Finally, we have all these four sizes available in the folder. So this is what these four lines means. Okay, now we will get this 1240x700 size. Copy this string and come to the single page and find where your image is. Here it is. Now replace the function echo get the post thumbnail URI let's see if this function works. Then we will add some more things. Refresh the page. Yes, it's getting the thumbnail, but maybe it's not the size we want. Let's see. It's 1500x732, which is the actual size. So what we want is this custom size. Copy this string and in the double quotes add this thing. Save it. Now refresh the page. Okay, it's throwing an error. So first one will be get the ID and second one will be 1200x700. Refresh the page. Okay, now if you right click and inspect element, then you can see that it's 1240x700, our desired thumbnail size. You can also change the thumbnail size if you need for any other place. So let me just show you within the same line. If we copy another size 512x700, for example, and add it here, replace this string, save it and refresh the page. Then you can see it's that custom size for 512x700. But our desired size will be 1240x700 for this place. Okay, now as we replace our title, our thumbnail and our content, we will move forward to the home page. But first let's just remove other extra things. For example, this excerpt. Let's see. We will comment this excerpt for now. You can add it later. You can also add the links for fashion, style, news. These are the categories, links to the categories here, and also the author name here and the post date here. Because in the news website, you must have to display at least the news date. So we will remove this author name and author picture, but we will leave this date, and let me get the post date from our WordPress. Type echo get the post date. Or if you do not want to use echo, then remove the get and echo. Just the post date. Refresh the page. Fatal error. Let's just use get and echo. Still not working. Okay, it's just get the date, not post date. Save it. Refresh the page. And it's 3rd June 2021, which is the current date, and I just added this post. Okay, now we will remove the image and the author name. I'm just commenting these things because we may add them later. Let's comment these things. Okay. I think this is enough for the single page. Let's come to home page. And let's do the menu now and the logo. Scroll to the top. Let's just replace the header and add a common file for both single and the index.php. So from the header, copy all over to the top, press Ctrl X, or copy, cut the thing and add a function get header. Okay, now open a new file or save this file as header and empty it. Paste that code from the header here and save it. Okay, now do the same in single.php. From the header, remove everything which will include the menu as well. Remove the header and replace it with get header. Now refresh and see if it's working, and the single.php as well. Okay, both are working. Now the header is common in both files. We will have to change our logo now. The logo and other settings will need Redux framework. I'll add them to my next video. So in this part of the video, I'll add the menu. Currently, if we come to the header.php, then you can see that it's wrapped in the nav tag, and here we will add our custom menu sets. Now if you come to your backend, then you can see that there is no menu option in the appearance. First of all, we will add a menu option in our functions.php. Open your functions.php. At the end of the functions.php, we will add a new function. It's a hook, and hook is init, and our new function will be register my news menus. Copy this function name and add I'll add two menus, one header and one footer. But for now, let's just disable the footer menu, and the header menu name will be header-top-menu and my text domain, my news theme. Okay, save it and come to your backend. Open refresh the backend and you will see the menu option in the backend. Click on menus. Now we can add a new menu. Let's just add random things to the menu and see if it's working. I'll add a two-step menu so we can see the drop downs as well. Click on save menu and assign this to the header top menu. Click on save menu again. Now we will add this header top menu to our header here. So first of all, let's comment the actual nav menu so we can see live changes in our function and our menu at the same time. We'll add a function within PHP quotes which is WP nav menu. You can add arguments to this one, but let's just check if it's getting the menu. Refresh the page and it's getting it, but there is no style because the menu HTML will be different from our desired HTML. So copy this menu and let's compare it with our actual commented menu. Okay, it's a lot different. First of all, our wrapper is nav and then div container and then div menu primary. So we will have to add these things to our current menu. These arguments can be found on wordpress.org or you can Google them and use them here. I will just paste that default array here. And then we will use this default array within the WP nav menu option. So copy this variable array and paste it here. Now our container will be nav because in our commented menu here is the nav. Okay, the nav ID will be main menu, so copy this main menu ID and container class or container ID, paste it here. Now the class will be stick and these things, copy these and replace the menu class. Okay, remove this one and let's check again. So it somehow worked, but the menu disappeared. Let's see what happened to the menu. Okay, this was the menu which was sticky according to our scrolling. This will be sticky menu. So let's see which one is our main menu. Copy these things and also use them with our main menu. So here is our main menu. Place it with the function and remove the actual menu. Okay, echo is false. Let's give it true value and this one as well. Okay, it's getting the menu, but still not done. Let's see how the HTML in this menu now. Copy the outer HTML and compare it with our commented menu. Okay, nav is okay, ID is main menu, class is this one. Now we will have to add these two divs, the container and the primary menu, before we start the UL. So copy these and remove the UL nav ID because we already gave the nav ID here, and add these two divs before the UL menu and close these divs after the closing UL. Slash div and slash div. Now let's see what the results are. Remove this test nav and on the home page refresh. Let's check. Okay, it somehow worked, but not so correct. But for some extent, it's working. Now let's see what is the main difference. Copy, and you can see all these things are according to that theme. The primary div is container. The main div is nav. ID and class is correct. UL is correct. But after UL, let's see what class li class have. The current menu item, its menu items as children, and all other LIs are without any classes. So in our case, LIs are menu has children, current menu item. Okay, let's just edit our menu and shorten our keywords. Let's save the menu and check. Okay, the menu is okay now. Now all these other things, for example this copyright, the menu, these stylings, these will be added in the next video. Please subscribe to our channel and please watch our next video to complete this tutorial. Thank you.